Hey friends, welcome back to another Sunday Together. Today I thought, let's change it up a little bit. And we are going to start learning our key passage first today, which is another way of saying our memory verse or our key Bible verse, or there are many different names, but basically we're trying to learn scripture and memorize it. And does anyone know why it's important to do that? Well, there are a couple of reasons why it is important. It says in Psalm chapter 119, verse 11, "I have stored up your word in my heart that I might not sin against you." By knowing God's word and memorizing it, it helps us in our day-to-day lives. It helps us make good choices, wise choices. It helps us know more about God and his character, what he's like. It helps us grow closer to Jesus. It brings comfort to us, maybe when we're sad or lonely. It just helps us in so many different ways. And maybe when we're out and about doing something and someone might ask us about Jesus, we can remember a verse from our Bible that we learned, even like the one we're learning today. Philippians 2 verse 8, "He humbled himself by becoming obedient to the point of death, even to death on a cross." It tells us about Jesus and what he did, right? And then we can tell others about it. Jesus has all power in heaven and on earth, but he humbled himself. Jesus came to earth not only to live a sinless life, but to follow his Father's plan to rescue people from sin by dying on the cross. And we get to tell others about that. Jesus died on the cross to take the punishment of our sin so that we can be forgiven and be made right with God, right? Because our sin is what separates us from God, because God is holy and can't be around sin. But God sent Jesus to die on the cross for us. And hey, that reminds me of another verse that we've looked at, John 3:16. "For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish but have eternal life." So many verses that we've been learning in God's word that helps us live our lives to bring him glory, helps us not to sin, and helps us point others to Jesus. So many, many reasons why it's important to read our Bible and have it in our heart. And did you know that we're actually doing a Bible reading plan right now and working through Psalm and Proverbs? And we just read Psalm 119 earlier. So maybe talk to your parents or your grandparents if you want to join us and work through some of the Psalms and Proverbs together. Okay, friends, well, now it's time to sing some worship songs, so let's stand together.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Let's praise the Lord. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Let's praise the Lord. Let's praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Let's praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Let's praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Let's praise the Lord.
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
the Savior say, your strength indeed is small. Child of weakness, watch and pray. Find in me your all in all. Jesus paid it all to him I owe. Sin had left a crimson stain. He washed it white as snow. He washed it white. He washed it white. He washed it white, whiter than snow. And when before the throne I stand in him complete, I will lay my trophies down, all down at Jesus' feet. Jesus paid it all to him I. Sin had left a crimson stain. He washed it white as snow. Oh, sin had left a crimson stain. He washed it white as snow. White as snow.
Thanks for worshiping again with me, friends. Okay, so last week we started a brand new series, right? Anyone remember the name? Call it out, to the cross. That's correct. And last week we looked specifically at Jesus's triumphal entry. So when Jesus entered Jerusalem, and what was he riding again? A donkey. That's right. And what did the people do? They laid their palm branches and their robes, and they shouted in celebration, Hosanna, the king is here. Now today we're going to learn a story where Jesus was questioned. Now, some people were trying to trick Jesus by asking him hard questions, but Jesus spoke with wisdom. But first, do you guys remember our values? It's been a couple of weeks since we've talked about them. There are three of them, well, really four of them, right? Anyone remember our first one? Love God, that's right. And our second one? Love your neighbor, that's right, good job. And our third value? Be kind and obey. And of course, everyone together, number four, have fun. Wow, you guys have such great memories. Well, we've talked about these values before and looked at a verse specifically in Mark. Let's read it. Mark 12, 30 to 31. And it says, love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your mind and with all your strength. The second is this, love your neighbor as yourself. There is no commandment greater than these. Well, the neat thing about our story today is we're going to see this verse in context. So that means we're going to see the story around where Jesus actually said these words. So great. All right. So you guys know I like questions, right? And I like questions because they help us learn. They help us remember, learn new things. And like I said earlier, today our story is going to have some questions in it. Some religious leaders asked Jesus many questions, but their questions were hard and they were meant to trick Jesus into saying something wrong. But Jesus never says anything wrong. Today's Bible story comes from the books of Matthew 22, Mark 12, and Luke 20. These are the first three books in the New Testament are three out of the four Gospels. And remember, the Gospels tell true story. Well, the whole Bible tells true stories, but the Gospel specifically tells us about Jesus's life on earth. So let's listen to God's word to us.
Hello friends, it's me, Megan, and this is Jesse. Megan, wanna try to answer a riddle?
Sure.
Do you know what a riddle is?
Yes, a riddle is a question that is tricky to answer.
Good, okay. What comes down but never goes up?
Rain.
How did you know that?
I've heard that one before.
Oh, okay. Well, what gets wet while it's drying?
A towel.
Oh, man!
I'm sorry, Jesse. I'm good at riddles. You know who else is good at answering tricky questions?
Who?
Jesus. In today's Bible story, some of the religious leaders tried to trick Jesus by asking him hard questions. But no one can trick Jesus, and no question is too hard for him. Listen to the story. The religious leaders heard Jesus teaching, and they decided to try to trick him by asking him a question. Some men went to Jesus and said, "Teacher, we know you tell the truth. Is it right to pay taxes to Caesar or not?"
"Why are you trying to trick me?" Jesus asked. Then he told them to show him what money they used to pay taxes. The men brought him a coin. Jesus asked, "Whose picture is on the coin? Whose name is on it?" "Caesar's," they said. Jesus said, "Then give to Caesar what is Caesar's, and give to God what is God's." The men were amazed, and they went away.
Later, the religious leaders asked Jesus, "Teacher, which command in the law is the most important of all?" Jesus answered, "Love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, and with all your strength. The second most important command is like it. Love your neighbor as yourself."
A man said to Jesus, "That's right. Loving God and your neighbor as yourself is far more important than offerings and sacrifices." The man's answer was wise, and Jesus said to him, "You are close to God's kingdom." Then Jesus asked the religious leaders, "Whose son is the Messiah?" "David's son," they said. "How can that be?" Jesus asked. "David called the Messiah Lord. Why would he call his own son Lord?" The religious leaders did not know what to say, so they did not ask Jesus any more questions.
When the religious leaders asked Jesus questions, he answered with wisdom. Jesus is the Messiah, the Son of God. He came to show us what God is like. Jesus has power in heaven and on earth.
Another great story from God's Word. The religious leaders did not believe Jesus is God's Son, but we know that he is. Jesus is the Messiah. Jesus spoke with wisdom when he answered the religious leaders' questions. Jesus was wise. Jesus was also humble because he humbled himself to obey God's plan to save people from sin, right? And that leads us right into our big picture question. Anyone remember which one we're asking right now? It's a big one. It's super important. What did Jesus do to save us? Jesus died on the cross and rose from the dead. Jesus came to earth and lived a sinless life, but died on the cross for our sins. He conquered death. Jesus came to show us what God is like, right? And rescue us from our sin by taking our punishment so that we can be with God forever. When the religious leaders asked Jesus questions, he answered them with wisdom, showing that he is the Messiah. And Messiah means the anointed one, a king who would save. Okay, friends, now let's review our story with some questions. Were the religious leaders trying to trick Jesus with their questions? What do you think? Yes, they were. That's right. Question number two, what did Jesus tell the religious leaders to look at to answer their questions about taxes? A coin. Good job. That's right. Question three, how did Jesus answer the question, is it right to pay taxes to Caesar? He said, give to Caesar what is Caesar's and give to God what is God's. Good job. Next question, what command did Jesus say is most important? Love the Lord with all your heart, soul, mind, and strength. Good job. Question five, what did Jesus say is the second most important command? Love your neighbor as yourself. In Mark 12, verse 34, the second half, it says, and from then on, no one dared ask him any more questions. The religious leaders asked hard questions in hopes of tricking Jesus into saying wrong answers, but Jesus answered their questions with wisdom. He knew what they were trying to do. And then the religious leaders did not know what to say, so they did not ask Jesus any more questions. Now, friends, before we end today, I want us to end on one of the first verses we were talking about today. In Mark chapter 12, verse 30, it says, love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your mind and with all your strength. We need to love God with every part of us. Not just, you know, a little bit on Sunday, or not only when he answers our specific prayer requests, right? We need to love him with everything that we have. We know we are going to make mistakes, but God forgives us. We can tell him that we're sorry and ask him to help us make better choices next time, right? But when we love God with all of our heart, soul, mind, and strength, other people will notice and hopefully even ask questions to us that will allow us to tell others about the good news of Jesus. Friends, thanks so much for joining me today as we continue our series leading up to Easter. The good news of Jesus is good news every day, and I'm so glad we got to talk about it today. Can you bow your heads with me? Dear God, thank you so much for loving us. Thank you for sending your son, Jesus, to die on the cross for our sins and overcoming the grave, Lord. We just love you so much, and we pray that you would help us love you with all of our heart, soul, mind, and strength, with every part of us, Lord, that our lives would point to you and the good news of Jesus, Lord. We pray that you would be with those who are sick, that you would heal their bodies and make them well. For those who are sad or discouraged, we pray that you would give them comfort and peace and joy, Lord. And we pray for continued wisdom for us as we live our lives each day, and also for our parents, our grandparents, our church leadership, our government, Lord. We desperately need wisdom from you, Lord. So we just continue to ask for that. And yeah, we just ask all of this in your name. Amen. Friends, it was so great learning with you today, and I hope that you have a fantastic week, and I will see you next Sunday.